Hey guys, Gary Girl Detective here, and welcome back to Testimony of Sherlock Holmes. Yeah, the next video at the very least. So, yeah, first of all guys, thank you for 800 subs. You guys are amazing, you guys are awesome. And it's very, very insane, guys, because seriously, it's been a long time since I actually, like, began doing, like, hidden object gaming and detective games. And suddenly to rise since to such a number, it has been a really, oh my god, man. It's been an oh my god moment, it has been really insane. So I want to thank everyone for that, not only the people from YTA who actually encouraged me to do more, but also to the newer subs who are quite new to my content. Thank you so much for subbing. I hope you enjoy your time here, and yeah, let's do this. So guys, before we get to the game, okay guys, a big warning here. This is going to be possibly the last playthrough of Sherlock Holmes for now. Because as I might have warned in the previous videos, yeah, this entire game tends to get very, tends to get very glitchy. Yeah, unfortunately guys, the glitchy part is that when I tried to resume back into the game after like a save crash, unfortunately I keep getting blue screened and I can't exactly like record anything beyond like the point of the warehouse, so. Unfortunately, guys, the playthrough will have to stop for now until if I get a new computer and if I get a new video drive that somehow gets the game working again. Because try as I might, there's no actual real like, answer. So, yeah, if anyone has any ideas on how to fix it, please feel free to comment down in the description below. I really appreciate it because I know many fans here want the entire series to go on. And, yeah, unfortunately, due to the glitches, we'll have to, yeah, I have to end like this, so. Yeah, sorry, buddy. I'm extremely sorry. However, guys, yeah, I'll be doing more Sherlock Holmes games, possibly Sherlock Holmes Crimes and Punishment for now, because, yeah, it's been a really big honor, and, yeah, I just got killed there. So, hope you guys all enjoyed this video, and, yeah, guys, be sure to leave a like, sub, and fave for more, because, yeah, like I said, I'll be doing more Sherlock Holmes games, like Crime and Punishments, and also The Devil's Daughter, and also maybe, like, the older games like The Awakened and Sherlock Holmes vs. Jack the Ripper and The Hound of the Baskervilles. Yeah, I'll actually definitely be doing that, so if you guys are interested in more Sherlock Holmes, please let me know down in the comment section below and I'll be sure to check it out. And by the way, when Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1 is released, we'll definitely be doing that as well, so yeah, stay tuned to that. So guys, hope you guys all enjoyed this entire playthrough. Unfortunately, this is going to be the last one. I'm really, really sorry until the glitches can be fixed. So yeah guys, hope you guys all enjoy, and of course guys, stay tuned everybody, and peace out.
Holmes! I knew you were in there! Holmes! Open this door immediately!
I think that I would rather not.
Tell me the truth, Holmes! I need to know! You have no right to keep the truth from me! Tell me!
I am sorry, Watson.
Open this door, or I will break it down!
Do what you like. The door is not locked.
You've driven me to this!
It's the police! Open up!
Why did it have to come to this, Holmes? All those years of friendship and respect, of trust. Everything that we went through together. And you deceived me all along, damn you. I wish that I had seen through all of your lies. But now, it is over. It is all over.
After so many days of relentless investigations and sleepless nights, I returned to the Thames area, to the very place where the bishop's nephew had died. I only had one trail left to explore, one last desperate attempt to understand recent events. I descended into the putrid, dark, suffocating depths of the town, the sewers. The fresh breeze from the Thames gave way to the stale, dank air of the dark tunnels. A shadow moving through an underground labyrinth, tormented, wandering through this humid, oppressive purgatory. What I might find mattered little. The most important thing was to keep moving. I can see something. This butt is still dry, despite the surrounding damp. It was thrown here not so long ago. Let's be careful. Oops! This bar has come away in my hands. The bars are completely rusty. The bars on this grate are completely rusty. This will be useful. An iron ring. This must be a service trapdoor used to release the water in the event of the sewers overflowing. That's of no use. This must be a service, an iron ring. That's of no use. That's of no use. A boat! I'm on the right track. I must cross the canal to see who landed here. Wire! An iron ring. This must be a service trapdoor used to release the water in the event of the sewers overflowing. That's of no use. A piece of rope that floats. If it's long enough, then it might be useful. It's very heavy. A body! Oh, it was weighed down by the anchor. If I can retrieve the anchor, I can use it as a grappling hook. There. An iron ring. This must be a... That's of no use. First try. Now, let's pull the boat back here. The boat is tied up on the other bank. It's impossible to pull it back to me. It will be better not to jump. I really don't fancy falling into that foul mud.
This must be a service. That's of no use. This must be an iron ring. It will be better not to jump. I really don't fancy falling into that foul mud. That's of no use. This must be That's of no use. That's of no use. This must be a service trapdoor used to release the water in the event of the sewers overflowing. The trapdoor is horizontal and solidly fixed. An old scarf with blood on it. This bit of iron seems new and looks like a piece from ordinary machinery. Footprints. Someone has been here recently. Footprints. Someone has been here recently. I need something. Incredible! This grate is new and has a mechanical locking system. Thank you. Open. Come on, John. Courage.
Annie is another. See how you like that. Oh, and how does this feel? Don't think you like that much. That'll teach him. Let's see if I can break. So very glad to see you, Watson.
Whee! Yes, he's alive! The bad guys had better watch out now. Grandpa's alive, and he is a good man. I knew that he was. Uh-oh, they're going to be sorry now. My grandpa rules.
Yes, and my grandpa saved him. Read it.
You are alive. I don't know what to feel, relief or regret.
Watson, my friend.
You are not in a good state, Holmes.
Neither are you.
I suppose not. Can you walk?
Not without your help.
Why did you fake your own death? And who were those men?
I have to carry on with the investigation alone. John, I'm innocent. I'm not an accomplice of those men. Look at me. Do I look as though I could be their boss? Am I in a position to give such orders?
What a relief. Oh, my God, what a relief. But how...
Curare, hemlock, a few Indian plants and sheep's blood to create the impression of death. A pathologist who owed me a favor for the death certificate.
Holmes, I was talking about this affair of...
I will explain everything, my friend, but we must leave here.
Yes, let's go back to Baker Street. I'll help you. Lean on me.
Home at last. I have missed this old room very much, Watson.
I put everything back in place after Baines went through it, but I didn't stay here. I couldn't face it.
Sit down, my friend. It is time for you to know the full details of this case. First of all, I must apologize for the distress that this has caused you, and for my behavior, which was, I know, quite abominable. I can only hope that by the end of this explanation you will understand that I behaved in such a way only to protect you, and that it caused me great pain to see your trust and confidence in me ebbing away.
From whom or what did you wish to protect me?
From Professor Moriarty.
Moriarty?
We should not have taken pity on him in that Swiss asylum. Do you remember during the case of the Awakened? Our indulgence has cost us dear today.
He's responsible for the bishop's murder?
Yes, but that was only a small detail in his plan. A detail which he had to eliminate, as it compromised the whole of his diabolical project. The bishop had in his possession a document which he suspected as being one component of a larger puzzle. The ramifications were unknown to him, but he considered the matter as sufficiently important that he should consult me. The day before our macabre discovery, his nephew, who was in his confidence, brought to him an important element which helped him understand Moriarty's grand plan. It was at that moment that two men began to comprehend the seriousness of the situation. The bishop then decided to contact me.
Against his nephew's wishes? Was that what they argued about?
Yes. But Moriarty found out that the bishop knew of his projects, and he arranged for his murder. The murderers were also supposed to bring back the document that the nephew, young Hampford, found, but they were unable to open the safe.
What was the document?
Evidence of Prince Woodville's implication in the project.
The nephew must have retrieved it from the Royal Archives, where he worked. A link to the crown.
Yes. Moriarty wanted to overthrow Queen Victoria and place the prince on the throne of England.
But that's impossible. He would have needed to create an incredible coup d'etat.
Patience, Watson. First of all, Moriarty placed his pawns so they might begin to develop and encourage a tense atmosphere, ready to discredit the Queen and thereby raise Woodville's popularity.
And provoke a famine so that the prince's soup kitchens could begin distributing food and he would appear as a hero.
Exactly. Moriarty quickly learned that I was making inquiries as to his plan and, without wishing to sound vain, he knew that I was the only person capable of upsetting his schemes. He therefore set up a plan that I be discredited and thought of as a criminal.
And you played along with him?
Precisely. Allowing him to believe that he had succeeded was the best way of ensuring that his attention was no longer fixed on me.
Why didn't you say anything to Scotland Yard?
Did you not think it strange that Inspector Lestrade was away for weeks?
What? You mean to say that Baines
was working for Moriarty?
I understand. The bishop's murderers were in the hands of this traitor, and you were therefore at a dead end after our investigations at the opium den.
Yes, and Baines' authority allowed him access to the police archives. He changed and forged all the charges in the documents that you saw at Judge Beckett's house. It was also he who substituted the Samoan necklace for a vulgar copy.
So that was why the judge went to Farley's, to obtain Baines' false information.
Precisely. But they each found themselves as instruments in Moriarty's strange orchestra. Judge Beckett received entire books full of charges against me, and a journalist such as Farley will not hold back when he gets the chance to make the front page of all the newspapers in England. With regard to Farley, it was a mere case of professional misconduct.
And to think that I held you responsible for the explosion at the judge's house. What a relief! But why did Moriarty have him killed?
He was on the point of discovering that all the documents supplied by Farley, and therefore by Baines, were false. Exactly the opposite to what our enemy was anticipating.
And where did the poison fit in all this?
Unfortunately, I do not possess all the information on this subject. The first time that we saw the effects of this substance on the body of the bishop, the poison was evidently only at an experimental stage. It was much too potent to do anything with.
Effectively. But in the second case, Kurtz, I didn't notice a great advance.
However, there was one. The poison was no longer fatal.
Yes, but the madness was still there. I should remind you that he attempted to devour his own dogs.
Correct, Watson. But it was not the second case, as you supposed. Remember the number of other incidences of madness, either collective or individual, relayed in the press in the days prior to it.
You mean to say?
That Moriarty tested this dangerous mixture on a large number of guinea pigs, apparently with little success, as all those people are now dead. I say apparently, because I do not have the least idea as to the result Moriarty was hoping for.
And that's where Hans comes in, isn't it?
Moriarty needed him to devise the substance's final formula.
And so you helped Hans to escape so he might lead you to it?
Yes, but things did not go as I had planned. The professor's men got their hands on him just after his escape.
And you lost his trail?
Yes, but I doubted that Moriarty would take Hans to his lair. To find him, I had only one trail, the bomb placed at the judge's house.
The trail of the three Russian brothers.
I found out about the mill by having the anarchist's trail followed by the children in my own secret police. Once again, their help was a determining factor. As regards knowing where to locate Moriarty's lair, I hoped to find the information in the attic of the water mill. I got to it only just in time before Baines turned up.
And you were stuck then, weren't you? Allowing him to arrest you would have meant certain death.
Regrettably. But Moriarty's plan worked in any case, as after killing Baines, I became England's most wanted man for the murder of a Scotland Yard inspector.
And so you had to make sure that people forgot about you. Therefore, you orchestrated your own death so that you might continue your investigation discreetly. Oh, that was a terrible time for me, Holmes.
I am sorry, my dear fellow.
Well, the important thing is that you are well and truly alive.
Yes, but it is not over yet. Moriarty will take action one day or another.
You were saying that you had found Moriarty's hideout. Where is it?
In an abandoned fun fair on the outskirts of London. It is quite certain that they are all there. Shielman, the Prince, and of course, Moriarty.
If Moriarty puts the Prince on the throne, he'll have his hands on the reins of the kingdom. Her colonies, her diplomatic network, her riches, everything.
Yes, including the army, the war fleet, everything he needs to help him conquer Europe. And eventually, I suspect, the world.
Holmes, we have to be quick. His plan hasn't been put into action yet. Perhaps it's not too late.
Let us go immediately, Watson.
Do you really believe that Moriarty is in there, behind that fence?
Something in the wind seems to suggest it, Watson.
I have a peculiar acid taste in my mouth, if that is what you mean, Holmes.
Well, yes. The air is tainted still with toxic fumes from the factory chimneys.
I believe that I read about this place. The funfair was abandoned after the factory was built so close by. It was said that even the ice cream tasted bitter.
Aren't you curious about the warehouse down there? There seems to be some strange activity taking place inside.
Strange and in keeping with Moriarty's activities. Let us go and see what they're up to.
With this cable car, we can get up onto the warehouse roof. This motor is from the cable car. There's a little petrol left, but not enough to start the motor. Empty. Judging by the smell, I would say that it's an oil reservoir. Look at this hole. This motor needs a starting handle.
Given the maintenance, this cable car isn't used very frequently.
True, Watson, but let us hope that it is still working. Cutting pliers, they could be useful. There is a metal ladder stuck under the cable car. The lever is stuck. This padlock seems rather old. I can't do that. I can't do that. That could be used as a weapon in a necessity. Vodka. There's a little at the bottom of these bottles.
Russian alcohol. Holmes, the three brothers.
There are two guards in front of the main entrance. We will have to find another way in. There are two guards in front of the main entrance. We will have to find another way in. and lever is stuck. A crank. Here is a good place to try and get through. This crate isn't large enough for us to get over the wall, nor to see what is on the other side. This motor is from the cable car. The crank is in place. Here's what we can use for fuel. Empty. Judging by the smell, I would say that it's an oil reservoir. The lever is stuck. A bottle of motor oil. This motor is from the cable car. Let us hope it works.
It works!
We are going to separate. I will find a way into the fair, and you must investigate the warehouse.
Very well, I'll do that.
There is no one on the roof. If the machine should get out of control, then just use the brake. There ought to be one.
I should hope so. Anyway, there's no other choice. And when I've found out what is going on down there, what should I do then?
Come and join me in the fairground. You can follow my route to get over the fence. Then you should find me easily enough. Good luck, my dear fellow.
Come on, John. Courage! No one seems to have noticed me. Now I must try to find out what is going on here. The bags contain rubble. They're tied up with good solid rope.
carts from the soup kitchens. They appear to be queuing up. I'll keep the rope. It's too dark inside this reservoir. It's impossible to see anything, but I can hear a slight lapping of water. A large dry cloth. It's impossible to reach the water. It's too far away. It's a miracle that this reservoir is standing. The feet are being eaten away by rust.